and it's gained its competitive edge in logistics and gained an advantage over UPS and the Postal Service in large part by coercing the tens of thousands of businesses that rely on its marketplace to buy its shipping services. We see this in all kinds of ways. Amazon has also used its marketplace to harvest data that then informs and aids its consumer products division. We've seen how it's used profits from AWS to cross-subsidize predatory pricing in its retail division. All of these abuses are because you've got multiple distinct lines of business under one roof. In other words, we have to restructure these companies because it's their structure that is the source of the problem. Their current structures are really designed to facilitate, incentivize, and ultimately conceal illegal monopolistic behavior. Second, breakups are not the only policy approach we need, but breakups are essential if the other policy approaches are to be effective. For example, it's now clear that Amazon functions as essential infrastructure. It provides the rails that other companies must ride to get to market. And therefore, Amazon's marketplace needs to be subject to some kind of public utility oversight to ensure equal access and fair terms. But if Amazon continues to operate as an integrated conglomerate, this oversight is unlikely to work. There are just too many transactions, too many subtle ways in which Amazon can influence and steer outcomes on its platform, that to create the oversight necessary would at the least necessitate a huge bureaucracy, and in any case would almost certainly not be effective. But if you break up Amazon into separate companies and remove those underlying conflicts of interest, then it becomes much more feasible to have oversight that's both light touch and also effective.